Savona. Upilo beginning law singing. Do you think you would sing, man? Lo beginning. La 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 la.
Sir, if you're referring to the Martin Boyle's choir, you left it way back there.
Late. I've had supper.
Fine.
Had a good day?
Nothing unusual.
White cells are O negative.
This is the latest X-ray of Peter the Brain, Doctor.
I see, the brain. It looks promising.
And this one is of Victor Collins. It was taken this morning. What do you think?
We'll go ahead with the transplant.
bravo, bravo, boys. Now, this really was great. Voices like angels. I've never heard a choir sing like this before. Hi, boys. A girl in a boys' choir. How did you get in?
Who are you? And how did you get in?
Well, very pretty teacher you got, boys, but she's not very bright. Well, tell her who I am.
Who?
Victor Collins, ma'am, the singer.
Well, what do you want here?
Madam, don't you recognize good fortune when it walks into your life? Well, just look at it. The place is dilapidated. I'd like to help the old school out if you'd let me. Say I were to join you and sing with the boys.
It's out of the question.
With my reputation, you'd fill any hall. Johannesburg, Durban, Bloemfontein,
Cape
Town. That's
just it.
What?
Your reputation. Do you think for a minute I want the boys' choir associated
with Victor Collins? The finest young tenor South Africa's ever produced?
That was 12 years ago.
10 years, I'm glad you remembered. You know, I came all the way across this mountain on horseback to join you.
There are other ways of traveling.
And you know that I'd fill any concert hall, and that means money.
Perhaps.
I wouldn't do it for charity, of course. I'd want my share of the profit. Say 50%.
I don't know what your father would have done then, darling. I can't say. But you know I'm sure that if he thought the school would benefit, well, I suppose there's a time when you're in such a stage, you must take a chance. Yes, you must take a chance.
You should have consulted with me about those photographs. And that stinking story you wrote.
You agreed I could do the article since you were away so much.
How could I expect that you would do anything like this to my friends?
You were with me when I took some of those pictures.
Which makes it all the worse. You used me to betray them.
It's my work, not yours.
You made them look like criminals in an American publication.
As a 2-year resident in this country, I have the right to an opinion.
There'll be no more articles. No more. Understand?
Don't give me any orders.
You're not in the States now. I'm not one of those gutless American husbands who give you the right to do anything you like, no matter what kind of a fool you make out of them.
Oh, Peter.
You're my wife, and you'll do as I tell you. The discussions are over, except for one thing. An apology from you to me, and to each and every one of my friends.
Do I apologize to the natives, too?
Morning, Mrs. De Bruyn.
There's no need to be polite. I know what you all think of me.
I'm so sorry. I won't have them insulted again. They're my friends, and I intend keeping them as my friends.
To hell with your wife, no matter who insults her. You South Africans make me sick.
You brought that on yourself.
It's comforting to know which bastard would throw the first stone.
Okay, chaps, all right. Okay, hold it, all right. Okay, what should we sing now? All right, pull yourselves together. Let's go, huh?
If you people want to go on tour, we'd better rehearse. Settle down, boys. Let's go again.
Tiritomba, 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 nello vernio te, tiritomba, 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 l'aria va, Serraggetta alla marina per trovare la morata. Gianca rossa graziata, fatta proprio pesciola. Tiritomba nell'Overnio te, tiritomba l'arma.
Tiritomba
nell'Overnio te,
tiritomba
l'arma. Tiritomba nell'Overnio te, tiritomba l'aria.
Tiritomba.
Serraggetta la marina per trovare innamorata. Gianca rossa graziata, fatta proprio pesciola. Tiritomba nell'Overnio te, tiritomba l'aria. Tiritomba l'aria va,
tiritomba.
Yes.
Well?
No, there'll be no divorce.
This is too stupid. You can't bear the sight of me and yet you want to drag it on.
There's never been a divorce in my family. I won't be the first.
For heaven's sake, don't set a precedent. When is this country going to come into the 20th century?
Spare me this American judgment of my country. I've had enough of it.
The great South African pride again.
In 4 years, you've caused enough scandal and drama in my life.
Why be so hypocritical?
Is there no way I can satisfy you? I brought you here to the Cape because you were complaining that life was so boring at home.
Just another mistake. At least there was a house in Johannesburg. Even if it wasn't a home.
What does that mean?
Nothing, Peter, nothing.
Are you blaming me again?
Oh, please don't jump on every word I say.
I agreed to adopt a child if that's what you really wanted. I agreed, didn't I?
It's too late. Maybe. Oh, I talk about it. It's much too late.
There will be no divorce, do you understand? No divorce!
Mr. Collins, please. You've missed your cue.
Yes. Yes, so I see.
Victor, please, we must have this rehearsal.
Well, I'll try my best, darling.
I know this doesn't mean anything to you, but to me, well, I'm not used to performing with a man.
Oh, well, let's try again. Come on.
For you makes me sing the song. I long for your love through the whole night long. Come dance with me, sing with me, kiss me and love me. True must our love forever be. Come dance with me, sing with me, kiss me and love me. True must our love. What sorrow this life may bring, my passion for you makes me sing this song. I long for your love through the whole night long. Come dance with me, sing with me, kiss me and love me. True must our love forever be. Come dance with me, sing with me,
me feel such a fool and so cheap. You have no principles whatsoever. All you care about is yourself.
Oh, but for all that, I'm irresistible.
No. You're pathetic. When a man doesn't believe in anything, he has to be pitied.
Oh, but I believe in myself.
You... Victor Collins, with all the opportunities you had when you were young, just think what you might have been.
Yes. Yes, but now I have my freedom.
Freedom? Then keep it.
Anne, I didn't mean to hurt you.
But you did.
Or maybe I've been away from people too long.
I think you've been away from life too long.
Oh, come on, Anne.
No, Victor. You're just using me.
And you think I haven't been used?
By me?
No. No, not by you, Anne.
Then what is it?
I mean by a bunch of thieves called Victor Collins Limited.
A bunch of thieves?
Yes, managers, agents, the usual parasites.
What do you mean?
Oh, Anne, when you and the boys sing, you sing because you love it. You sing to bring joy and happiness to others. Well, with me, it's like a banking operation. Calculated to give some bunch of bloodsuckers the best in jewels and champagnes.
There he is! Oh, he is.
Always coming, always more people each time to tell me how wonderful I was. How to organize my life.
Mr. Collins, you may be his manager. He is going to Europe.
He's not going to Europe. He's going to America.
He's quite right. Mr. Collins, as his parents, I think he must allow us to know what is best for
him.
Exactly.
Mrs. Collins, you may be his parents, but I am his manager, and I say he is going to Europe.
For the last time, I say he's going to the Metropolitan in America.
And I say he's going to Europe. He's going to Italy.
Mind your own, Sir John. Has he got a contract?
I have the contract right here, Mrs. Collins.
Personally, I never signed a contract with any agent. They always treated me like a boy. But they forgot that somewhere along the line I'd grown up.
And your public, too? The ones who genuinely accepted you for your talent. For being an artist.
You make me feel such a cad.
Not a cad, Victor. Lonely. Even in a crowd.
I got sick and tired of it all, Anne. You seem to know me better than I know myself.
It isn't very difficult when you care for someone.
Care for one?
When you love someone?
Love someone?
I know I'm making a fool of myself. But I love you, in spite of what you are.
Anne. Anne. No, no, Anne.
I'm sorry, Victor. But now you know.
Let's just have a final check on our rope before we carry on.
This little act of togetherness is quite unnecessary, you know.
I want to do the climb as much as you.
To prove what?
Proving things is your game, not mine.
What is that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Not a damn thing.
You haven't really had enough experience for a dangerous climb like this.
The guide said I could handle it. After all, it's one of the few things we learned to do together.
All right, let's press on.
Sing it again, or what do you want to sing? All right, let's sing the brick song altogether.
Now an ordinary brick is something very small, and you'd never even think a brick could count at all. But a brick upon 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 a brick can build a mighty wall. For the bricks stick together and stand brave and tall. For they know that all together they're a match for any weather. For together they will never, never fall. There are single flakes of snow inside a big snowball.
And single drops of water make a waterfall. And a brick upon 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 a brick can make a mighty wall. For the bricks stick together
and stand brave and tall. For they know that all together they're a match for any weather. And together they will never, never fall. La 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 la.
They are solitary fishes in a sardine hole, and 100,000 stitches make a knitted shawl. And a brick upon 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 a brick can build a mighty wall.
For the bricks stick together and stand brave and tall.
For they go together, they're a match for any weather. Together they will never, never fall.
There is something in the story of the brick for all. So use it when you need it like a trumpet call. Yes, a brick upon 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 a brick can build a mighty wall. For the bricks stick together and stand brave and tall. For they know that all together they're a match for any weather. And together they will never, never fall. La 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 la.
Bravo, bravo. All right, let's sing it again, boys. Can you believe it? Move on, old man. Go on. Move on. Go on, I'll give you a hand. Oi! Come on.
Toreador on guard now.
Toreador, Toreador, how dare an ass like you disturb the peace? La 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 la. Come on, boys, get out! Boy, come on!
Thank you.
when things go wrong. Music makes you happy, makes the world go round, brings you new horizons when new life can be found. Music is forever. Life is like a song. Brings you new horizons. Brings you new horizons. Brings you new.
Thanks for telling me, Doctor.
I'm afraid it's the only alternative. We'll have to do a transplant. Be patient. We'll have to find a suitable donor soon. He can't last very long in his prison condition. Mrs. DeBrett, your husband's heart can give a man a new life.
You should have consulted with me about those photographs.
You agreed I could do the article since you were away so much.
You made them look like criminals in an American publication. The discussions are over, except for one thing. An apology from you to me and to each and every one of my friends.
From every indication, however, the heart is totally undamaged and would fit the needs and requirements for the transplant I'm suggesting. Mrs. DeBrain, you've made the right decision. Thank you.
The brain is to be the donor, Doctor.
Correct. All tests prove positive.
Hello, Doc. How's the guy next door? Collins is almost ready. And here? He's fading fast. Be on standby.
Now, Mr. Collins, this is just a little oxygen just to make you breathe easier. Just breathe in. Dr. May is going to give you an injection now, and you'll be asleep. Okay, Doctor. Feeling all right? Keep your eyes open. Keep your eyes open for me. Just keep them all the time. Right, he's gone.
Dr. Mayfield, is the heart-lung machine ready?
Standing by.
How's the pressure?
Very good, Doctor. Everything ready?
Very well, let's start. Doctor, check blood sample.
Yes, Doctor.
How's the pressure holding?
Very good. Coming up to full capacity.
Everything according to plan?
Yes. Get the donor ready, will you?
Thank you.
There's no news yet. It's much too early.
They've begun.
It might take several hours yet.
I hate hospitals.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mrs. De Bruyne.
Everything according to plan?
Yes. Get it down already, will you?
Good morning, gentlemen. Please sit down. Last night, the heart team here at Groote Schuur performed another complete heart transplant. From every medical indication, the operation appears to have been a complete success.
Are the names to be released?
Not yet.
Even though it's common knowledge who they are?
In due time, Miss Parkins. In due time. Thank you.
I'm Adele Parkins. Have you reconsidered writing that article? It would go a long way in making up for the way these Afrikaners have treated you. Long, long way. Would you agree?
Why would anyone want to read something by me? Just because I permitted my husband's heart to be used in a transplant.
This, for a start.
A few contrasting pictures. Something that struck me at the time.
If we do the right kind of book, it can get into every bestseller list all over the world, I guarantee it.
A scandalous sensation.
The country deserves it. It needs a shake-up.
Why don't you do it alone, then?
I'm only a journalist. It's you who's got the personal story to tell.
An interesting point.
What?
If I want to exploit what has happened, why do I need you?
We'll be so happy if you would come back to the school. We all miss you.
That's fine. Now, will you give me some peace and quiet?
Victor would come over you. You seem to have changed so much over the last few weeks.
Well, if I have, it's my own business. Why don't you leave me alone?
If you want me to.
Yes, I want you to go. Why don't you go back to the school? That's where you need it.
Victor!
I'm serious.
Sterile ward. Mrs. De Bruyne is here. Do you want to see her?
Of course, I've been wanting to see her for weeks.
Please send her in. There can only be one visitor at a time.
Then you'd better go.
I'll be back tonight.
Are you all right? Shall I call someone?
No, it's nothing.
Are you sure?
Yes. Please don't tell them.
Who?
The reporters, they're out there, aren't they?
A few of them.
Yes. They won't leave me alone. They're just looking for some sensational story.
You're a celebrity.
No, I'm nothing. The doctor is. Isn't it strange to you?
What?
I mean this. Your husband's heart in my chest.
I don't think of it like that.
Must have meant something to you.
Yes, well, as you say, somewhat strange. Perhaps curious.
No more?
No.
I don't believe you. Did you love him very much?
Peter is dead.
And I'm alive. Why? I've been given a new life. Please help me to accept it. Will you? Will you?
Thank you.
What's wrong, Victor?
I'm all right. Cares? No one actually cares.
Didn't I organize this concert for you last night? Didn't you have a devoted audience out there waiting for you?
My voice, my talent, not me personally.
Do you think that's why I've stuck by you here for over 3 months? To exploit you?
Either that or pity. I'm nothing special to you, Joyce.
You realize you're only trying to justify running away again.
I've been through this before, and I resent being used.
It's entirely different.
Because I've had an op?
I mean, people from all over the world with cardiac conditions will know there's real hope. What's changed, Victor? Until this morning, the tour was something you wanted.
It's because I felt guilty, that's why. That's why I had to do it. You've got a sacred talent, Victor. Share it with the world. Go on. Sing for your supper, my lad. Sing for God and country. Don't you understand, Joyce? I'm a freak. And this operation's made it more obvious.
First, you're not worth anything and should be dead. Now you're a martyr.
You see, even you think I'm a freak. A psychiatric case study, not a man.
What do you expect? Surely you can't have deluded yourself into some romantic notion that we're mystically and inseparably bound together by what's happened.
Oh, that's stupid.
It's not realistic. I told you at the outset, I don't identify with the surgery, and nothing has changed since then.
In other words, you care for me as much as you did for your husband.
If you want help, get it from a professional.
I want it from someone who cares. Someone who really cares, not a stranger.
Someone you can manipulate, you mean?
Manipulate?
You're a master at it.
Ah, go on.
Running again?
Yes, Doctor, running again. Go on. You give an analysis.
Look around. You've never had to work for anything in your life. Not even your sacred talent. Look at this house. Look at what you've come from.
I've turned my back on all this.
Of course you did. To create that sweet, lovable vagabond, Victor Collins. Dear Victor, the finest exploiter of them all. Who have you ever cared about? Name one person that's better off for having known you.
You ask yourself that question.
I'm not the one who's begging for understanding or forgiveness. You want it both ways. You want to be a bastard and you want people to love you for it.
All right, at least I know now that I've been wasting my time expecting anything from you.
No, Victor, don't go. I know you've no further use for me. I'll be the one who runs this time.
And here now is the latest news from the medical world. Victor Collins has now been missing from his home for 3 days. Doctors at Kritzkir are quoted as saying that there is no immediate danger. Because Victor Collins's condition since his discharge from the hospital 7 weeks ago has been excellent. and there have been no indications at any time of the rejection syndrome usually associated with this period of recovery after a heart transplant. In fact, there have been persistent rumors that Mr. Collins is actually preparing a concert tour early next year to emphasize the completeness of his recovery, as well as to pick up a career he renounced many years ago.
Stop, stop. Can't you hear? That's wrong. You seconds, listen. Right? That was better. Now let's try again. Ready?
Seen him.
I've told the police and reporters. He hasn't been here, and I don't think he'll come back.
You were very good to him.
Yes. When he needed me.
I'm sorry.
You needn't be sorry. I'm old enough to know what I'm doing. God knows, I'm old enough.
Anne, would you lie for Victor?
Lie? Not likely. I don't want to see him again. You're too young. You won't understand.
It's Uncle Victor, isn't it? Remember, you promised to sing with the choir tonight. The parents are waiting.
I won't be long. Thank you.
A new life, that's what you've given me, Doc. I'm not referring to the heart. A mess of things I've made.
That's okay. I'm pleased you came back.
I think from now on, it'll be a matter of understanding and acceptance.
So you've come to terms with yourself. Well, that's fine.
Joyce.
How is he?
We kept him here for a few days for some tests. But otherwise, he appears to be in good shape. You can go in now. He wants to see you.
Thank you, Doctor. I don't think I will.
Hey, Doc. You seen Joyce?
She's just left.
I wanted to see her. I must see her. Joyce! Joyce!
South Africa Airways, Bang 727, on flight SA312, to Jan Smuts Airport, Johannesburg, for now before.
Name one person that's better off for having known you.
You make me feel such a fool and so cheap. All you care about is yourself. A man who doesn't believe in anything has to be pitied.
I think I've been away from people too long.
No, Victor. You're lonely. Even in a crowd.
Why don't you go back to the school? That's where you need it. Been away from people too long.
You've been away from life too long, and you only cared about yourself. That's why you've never really seen other people. A man who doesn't believe in anything has to be pitied.
I think I've been away from people too long.
And you only cared about yourself. That's why you've never really seen other people. It's not very difficult when you care for someone.
Till the stars have lost their glory till the new moon turns to blue, till the sun no longer rises. I will always worship you till the lilies fade and wither, till the roses lose their hue, till the dew you